Welcome from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's do some quick drawing examples of simple sp3 hybridized atoms. So as we look at the screen, let's remember sp3 hybridization. How do we get sp3 hybridization? Well, we need to take all four of our valence atomic orbitals, second row element, so we have an s and three p's, and I'm going to label these with axes now for our p orbitals. Take all four of these, we combine them, and we get four sp3 hybrid orbitals. Note that since we used all three p's, then we have x-axis properties and y-axis properties and z-axis properties, and that allows our sp3 hybridized atoms to occupy three-dimensional space. And so that's an important thing. When we show these, we want to make sure we give them this three-dimensional quality. So here is a sample atom. This will be an sp3 hybridized atom. Off of this atom, we will have four groups. These represent our four hybrid orbitals, and we're going to put them in three-dimensional space. Two of them we will draw as regular lines, and these are going to have about a 109-degree bond angle. It's really 120, but it's easier to draw 120 than 109, but it's very close to 109. The remaining two groups, we draw sort of coming off the atom in the same direction, and we draw them slightly differently. One, we make a wedged line, and that means that line is actually coming above the plane of the writing surface. The other one is called a hashed line, and that means that line is going below the plane of the surface. So we're trying to impart this three-dimensionality to this picture. When we do this, we always have four things coming off the central atom. Two will be separated by about a 109-degree bond angle, and they'll be in the plane of the writing surface, and the hashed and wedged lines will be coming off in very similar directions, completing our three-dimensional picture. Okay, let's see an example. Let's see methane. Methane is CH4. We've seen this molecule many times. It's a sp3 hybridized carbon, and we draw our four groups coming off of the carbon, the sp3 hybridized carbons, and we stick hydrogens on the end. That's it. That's methane. That's a tetrahedral center. It doesn't have to be drawn exactly this way. This is sort of an upside down picture. As long as we have four groups coming off, and the two groups that are drawn in a regular fashion, regular bonds, are separated by about 109 degrees, and we have a bolded atom, a wedged atom, and a hashed atom, we've drawn this correctly as an sp3 hybridized atom. And of course, we know this has tetrahedral geometry. Let's look at ammonia, NH3, very quickly. We can make these three lines for our hydrogens. That means the fourth group has to be in the plane of the writing surface. The fourth group is a lone pair. Normally, we draw lone pairs with lobes. Not lopes, but lobes. Your instructor may prefer to have a line with two dots on the end of it. Either way is fine, at least fine for me. I tend to prefer the lobes. But that's one picture of ammonia. We could draw this differently. We could put the lone pair coming out of the plane of the writing surface instead. And I'll try to draw that a little darker as if it's wedged. That would be fine. These are both ammonia. They have a trigonal pyramidal geometry. And let's finish with water, another simple example. Most people would probably draw water in this way. The two in-plane groups are your hydrogen atoms, and the two out-of-plane groups coming off in about the same orientation are two lobes for lone pair, trying to show that one is sort of in front of the other. That's one way, but we could draw it differently. We could have a lone pair in the plane coming off the top, and then another lone pair sort of wedged over here, and a hydrogen going back. As long as we have four groups coming off, two are in the plane, two are out of the plane, and our geometry is bent. So it's important to be able to draw these structures, because the whole reason we did hybridization was to learn about bond angles and geometries. Well, once you know bond angles and geometries, you want to be able to show your atoms in three-dimensional space in as accurate a way as possible. This is a means of communicating with other scientists when you draw these pictures. So practice these skills a little bit and improve them so you're a better communicator.